I've said it before, and I am sure I will say it again, but for all the complexity in climate science, there's only really one number that you really need to understand in order to stop it. Zero. Zero is what we need to get overall CO2 emissions to if we want to stop the world heating up. And if, like me, you enjoy things like stable weather conditions, enough food and water, and not living underwater, then stopping the world heating up is a very good idea. Zero may seem like a simple number, but it hides the fact that getting to net zero emissions overall is an incredibly complex task.
I think you'll find that no, it isn't.
Oh, hi. But yeah, sure it is. Decarbonizing electricity using just renewables is tough since they work intermittently. Plus, we don't just burn fossil fuels for electricity, we also use them for everything from getting around to industrial products, things which are even harder to decarbonize.
But what if there were a fuel that could do all these things, all without emitting carbon dioxide?
I mean, yeah, that would be great, but we'd obviously need huge amounts of it.
Well, you're never going to believe this, but this fuel only happens to be made of the most common element in the universe. Hydrogen.
So, like, hydrogen gas?
Yep, that's right. Two hydrogens bound together. And this simple little molecule has some amazing properties. It packs more energy into a given weight than fossil fuels, but it doesn't release carbon dioxide when we burn it. And the water vapor that it does produce
can't heat the planet by itself, even though it's
a greenhouse gas. Yeah, I know. I watched your video.
Well, I'm glad to hear it. But hydrogen gas doesn't actually exist naturally, does it?
Sure, but you can easily make it, say, just using water and renewables.
Well, honestly, this sounds too good to be true.
Yeah, that's because it is too good to be true.
Oh, hi, Rosie. This is Rosie Barnes, a renewables engineer with a YouTube channel all about the engineering we need to tackle climate change.
Hi.
Hello?
Oh, yeah. And this is...
Me.
Okay, so Rosie, you don't agree with me that hydrogen could be used to power pretty much everything.
Well, I guess it could, but just because it could doesn't mean that it should. The biggest issue is that you waste, like, a lot of energy by converting electricity to hydrogen and then burning it. About two-thirds of the energy is wasted. If you compare that to just 10% waste for using electricity directly or storing it in batteries.
Yeah, but how much difference would that actually make?
Well, just compare what we'd need for a battery electric car to a hydrogen fuel cell car. So for every one wind turbine or one solar panel that you'd need for your electric car, you'd need about 3 wind turbines or solar panels to fuel your hydrogen-powered alternative.
Okay, sure, it's technically challenging, but we do need to decarbonize all these sectors.
Yeah, I mean, if we give up on hydrogen, aren't we giving up on this decarbonization challenge?
No, but we have to decide where the challenge is worth it. So every sector that can be directly electrified will use our renewable electricity much more efficiently. So for many things like passenger cars, home heating using heat pumps, anywhere we can use a more efficient kind of electricity storage, such as pumped hydro or lithium-ion batteries, using hydrogen for those things means we'd need up to 3 times as much renewable electricity.
But I noticed how you said for many sectors.
Yeah, I noticed that too.
Yes, that's true. There are plenty of applications that aren't easily electrified. For example, long-haul flights and shipping, and lots of industrial processes like steel manufacture.
So hydrogen could help make those sectors more green.
Potentially, but it's not a quick fix. For hydrogen to make sense, we need to get better and cheaper at making, transporting, and storing it. Even though hydrogen carries more energy for a given weight than fossil fuels or batteries, it takes up lots more space. That could make hydrogen-powered planes a problem.
Excellent alliteration.
Thanks, but you wrote that line.
But storing and transporting renewable energy is a big challenge. So if we could get much better at that with hydrogen,
wouldn't that mean we can transport it to where it's needed and store it until it's needed?
Yeah, we can, but you just need to remember it's not the only way to transport or store electricity. Long-distance connections between grids are getting longer and more efficient, and alternative storage technologies are developing fast too. So yes, hydrogen could play a role, but it's not going to solve the problem single-handed.
So I guess that me has to admit that hydrogen isn't some silver bullet that's going to revolutionize everything just yet, and that many of the things that it solves may be better off tackled by tech we already have today.
Okay, sure. But then Rosie has to admit that hydrogen could still play a key role in certain areas that are hard to solve with the tech we have today.
Yeah, I have literally been saying that the whole time. Hydrogen made from renewable energy could definitely help us decarbonize.
Glad that you finally admit it.
Green hydrogen is definitely going to play a much bigger part of our future energy mix than it does now. But since we don't have unlimited renewable electricity, unlimited money, or unlimited engineers, we need to make the most of our limited resources to transition to our zero emissions future.
Well, I think we've all learnt something today, huh? And if I've learnt one thing about climate change solutions, it's that there's no one climate change solution. Which is why I love Rosie's channel so much. It explains all the things that work and don't work about all our energy engineering tech.
Adam and I have also just made a video on that essential climate change number, zero. Why do we really have to get all the way to net zero? And does the how matter just as much as the how much? You can find that video over on my channel now.
And don't forget to subscribe to Rosie while you're there. Okay, until next time. Bye.
Bye.
Glad you finally admit it.